education to our students. Guerra and Dr. Ghosh is being published here. But he has many concerns with the academics. Dr. Mike Guerra is admitted vice president and chief operating officer at Lincoln University, California. He provides strategic leadership and management of administrative operations for the university. Also, so as associate professor of business administration, Auckland, and highly interested in education field, and has taught undergraduate, graduate, and doctoral courses in import export management, organizational behavior, operational management, organization development, strategic management, and international management for about 10 years in United States, Canada, Singapore, China, Vietnam, Nigeria, and Ethiopia. He has also acted as a dean of faculty at Auckland campus of this university for more than 5 years and upheld standard of teaching at the university and overseas faculty development. He specializes in working with NGO. He has vast experience of working with organizations in Thailand, Vietnam, Cambodia, Nigeria, the Russian Federation, and the United States. He also serves as an associate professor of business administration, Auckland. I welcome you at this occasion in front of the Dallas floor of the university. Mr. Uday, Kumar, Ghosh is, you know, Indian. Ghosh is an inspirational and charismatic leader with sharp business or acumen and analytical intellect. Recently, he is a president and advisor of Lincoln University, International Business Development of Lincoln University. He shoulders several responsibilities like CEO and board member of Europe and Asia, managing director, real-time artist at Europe, Asia, managing director, Africa, and Middle East. He has over 20 years of business, market, sales experience in MNC. Mr. Uday Ghosh thrives in entrepreneurial and innovative businesses in the management of e-learning, consultancy, international networking, social media networking, supply chain, and brand building to name you. I thank Dr. Ghosh for spending a 3 day entirely with this university, and is one of the things which I tell you that is best compliments to all of us. Dr. Ghosh has visited almost all countries, different universities, and he frequently visiting IIM and IITs in India, and he has complimented us nothing like the different universities having to offer the student have comparable seen to any IIT which we are. Welcome to the Western Design and on behalf of all of us on society and society.
We also have with us Mr. Uday Kumar Ghosh, President's Advisor, International Business Development, Lincoln University, USA. I will request our deputy sir again. Welcome, sir.
So these students are coming to Lincoln City Group, is a very big bank, Google, Apple, Deloitte, they are all working. I can share with you guys, these are really fascinating things that LinkedIn offer proximity to the top universities. So that is a great advantage when you come. Because when you try to get into a bigger school, you pay much, much higher. Because LinkedIn, as Dr. Rakesh says, it's very affordable and very frankly, it's almost at the cost of you study here. It's below $18,000 for the MBA program, which is absolutely fascinating for you to take your own. And the biggest advantage for LinkedIn to be any other university is the location. It's in Silicon Valley. And you so Silicon Valley, everything happens in Silicon Valley. And it is quite safe. We have a fantastic sort of housing facility and the university is located. You can travel communities absolutely very, very it's like the communities, the partition, which is the metro station, just 1 minute away from the university. So having said that, we have a very good faculty also at the university, and our professors, our faculty, they come from UCLA, from UC, from Purdue, from Stanford, and they are also teaching in LinkedIn. So that is a great opportunity that you have. So I would like to say that LinkedIn is one of the finest in the media in terms of education at an affordable situation. LinkedIn is also a non-profit. So that's why we are not so expensive, because every institute is profit. We are non-profit. So I work as a managing director for a multinational company. I work for Sony, I work for First, I work for Grundig. After having served the corporate world in 80 markets around the world, I chose to get into academia. And I'm very happy associated with Lincoln, and I'm taking care of international honoraries and type of various universities from here, we're going to Asia, and countries will travel. So I must say that I'm very pleased here, and I wish you all the best and good luck. And whatever we can do with our partnership, is basically to give you an opportunity from Ganpat to the university to try and come and explore the opportunities that we provide. And America is the economic dream, as you know. Even with restrictions, whatever you think that, oh, it's very restricted. Every year, last year, 152,000 people, 252,000 people, students went to America. So people keep going. So don't keep that. You have to appear the interview in front of the visa officer. There's nothing wrong. As long as you know the purpose of your going, and it's as simple as that. In 1 minute, visa will be approved if the visa officer gives you the right to go to US and study. So there is, you don't have the kind of question about whether I will get it or not. Your job is to do is be positive and fight for it, and I'm sure you will get it through. So I wish you guys all the best and good luck, and looking forward to seeing you and some of you in at the university. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much for showing great luck to the students. Now we have with us Dr. Mike Vera with us, and I invite him to share his thoughts on possibilities, opportunities, and sensitivities at USA, the Lincoln University. Please, sir.
So, you know, it's very interesting coming here. It's my first time being, I have to tell you, everybody said I was going to leave the plate, that's not going to happen. The hospitality, the food, the people have been great in just the 2 days I've been here. But why are you here? You know, part of it is when you first come to people from a different school, it's kind of like the first time you go to a dance, and you ask that special person, or you hope to be that special person, if they'll dance with you. You never know until you dance and see if there's some chemistry. Well, one of the things, a retired police chief is a lot of politicians. And politicians will always tell you what you want to hear. Ghana, and the entire staff, is they're authentic. And that was one of the reasons why I started with Lincoln. When I got offered to do that, when I had choices to work at other places, I was still a chief of police. And I chose Lincoln because people care. The faculty care. They actually spent time with the students. The students were interested. The students were very diverse. We had students in one academic year, students from 54 different countries, which you get to interact with. And so, when you start with a relationship, and it seems to work, there's authenticity on both sides. And I wanted to be inspired. I was trying to be, you know, think of some words for you. From our tour campus today, taking not just the theoretical knowledge, but actually application from the maritime, the pharmaceutical, to the engineering, everything. It was wonderful. Those are the goals for learning outcomes we all instructors to achieve for our students. And so, you know, I think we try to do the same thing at Lincoln. So we get essentially more of the same as far as how faculty meet you, how fellow students interact. So that's a wonderful opportunity here. The other part is the Gallup organization just finished studying. They've been studying management and jobs and jobs and screen applicants for the last 80 years. And their most recent study shows that Generation Z and Millennials, which many of you are aware of, is you're not looking for what we would consider the traditional outcomes for employment, where you want to have a family, a house, and things. Overwhelmingly, according to the research now, it's 200 different countries. They didn't just limit to the U.S. They've been studying for a long time worldwide. Is you all want a good job. That's what you want. The number one issue, you want a good job. And so, like you get the same opportunity here, Lincoln can offer you complimentary degrees, a complimentary education, where we continue the same, more the same. Although, you'll be a little bit different, right? Because you're not studying here. You're studying in the U.S., you're studying with people from different countries, whether in Africa, Eastern Europe, Asia. I travel quite a bit to Vietnam. So, to be a wonderful opportunity to work with other people in different cultures, which is what the workforce now. So not only do you get sort of the helping hand, the coaching that goes along with a good education at the institution, but you would also get an opportunity to see how others work, how others think, how others approach problems differently. And I'll tell you, that's why I went to Lincoln. I got tired of teaching. I've been teaching American students since 1988. I was 23 years old when I started teaching. And quite frankly, it gets kind of boring. You see the same type of people, you teach the same type of thing. At Lincoln, it energized me. I got different viewpoints, different ways of approaching problems. Remember, there's not only one solution. There could be five or six different alternatives that are equally, deal with the issue. So that's one thing that you'll be able to get at Lincoln. Is those are opportunities, multiple opportunities in all your courses. International perspective, different things. With, in context of using the American educational system, the American textbooks. Right? And what does that mean? It means also you learn sort of American theories of management. Are those always going to work if you come to India? No. It's the same as it's not going to work if you come home to Vietnam or Bangladesh or all. You change it. Modify it. You take the theory and you learn how to modify it and make it work for you. Maybe it won't work for you. You know what? There's plenty of theories and ways of dealing with things. This, you learn how to approach things differently using different theories, how you can learn to modify it to work for the working environment that you're currently working in, whether it be at home or whether you get a multinational job working in Australia or Ghana. So I invite you, because I'm talking about class. I'm a little nervous as a parent. And so I understand what you're going through. I understand what your parents might go through. So if your parents have questions or ideas, you know, sometimes they, you know, my son's going to school pretty low, and I'm still worried about him. You can only imagine your parents doing traveling, you know, a 15-hour airline and staying there. Well, tech is wonderful. It's a lot of time. They don't see you as much in person. They don't smell you. They don't touch you. So that can be concerned. So the homesickness is an issue. And so if we can answer or treat issues you have at any time, we're always welcome. Like, can I through staff here or through Dr. Ghosh here? We can address this issue. I'm also the part of my judge.
Warm and welcome to you, both of your ladies. I'm Dr. Falguni, and I'm interested for my son's education in your university for DM. So I want to ask you some questions. Whether you are providing us I-20 from your college so that we can apply for the student visa?
So much. Yes, what happens is there is an application form. I mean, you apply for it, university admission office checks the credentials of the applicant, your son, right? Yeah, and then if he is then we that's called a visa. So you will have that and include the admission acceptance later. Then okay, so that will be 1 year to university. And after which your son has to apply for the appointment with the U.S. Embassy consulate.
Okay.
And biometric. So this appointment, and he has to fill this form, which is around 300 words. So that is done. So in order to ask your question, that if one of the items you need to by the university.
Yes. Second thing I want to know that for first year they are learning here in the university, first or second year both in Ganpat University. So, how will you count the credentials or that marksheet?
It's a great question. It is, I'm talking from the academic perspective. So, what happens is we have been working with Ganpat University for the last 1 year to set the program right. What happened is we need to map the set right. In courses, the courses are talking
same course.
Say, suppose it is an MBA or marketing or BS program with agronomic imaging. Our syllabus is here with the syllabi of Ganpat University, and we combine together in a way that is for our syllabi, the course has to be matched or mapped with the syllabi of Ganpat. So, when the student having 1 or 2 years here, they are actually studying the same courses that being taught in LinkedIn.
So, and you are sending the faculty to here to
of course. Of course, we will also send the faculty here. Because, and then what happens is, the bachelor course is around 42 courses, or bachelor's degree program, 42 courses. So, around 30 courses will be taught, around 20 courses will be taught here by the professor, and 18 courses will be taught there. And then only they will get the double degree.
Okay.
They will get a double degree. And the advantage of the double degree is absolutely fascinating, because you will have the full degree from Ganpat, you will have a full degree from Lincoln by being here. If they are not going, if we are going there, they will get the full degree from Lincoln as if they studied 3 years in Lincoln. And then they will have the facility of internship and well, 6 months and another 18 months of the optional training, optional training, OP. So 18 months internship they will get. So that is a great advantage for the student. And if the student wants to go on study in any university in America, they'll have the full transfer of the study in American Institute.
Okay. So I want to ask that especially in the, it is a diagnostic imaging course.
Correct.
And in which the patient, they have to come the experience of clinical experience also. In your information, it is that you are sending to the clinics and hospitals and fourth field. So the students can accommodate that facility. So in which there is a paid internship or just they have to fourth year is paid internship or non-paid.
Yeah. First of all, of science in diagnostic imaging, when they complete the fourth year of course, they are getting the degree from Lincoln, after which it is not internship, it is externship.
Okay.
In MBA or BBA, we call internship, but for so far, the Bachelor of Science in diagnostic imaging, we call externship. When they do the externship, they get paid from where they work.
Okay. So, there is registration of some...
And the advantage of that is not only that you're getting a graduate from Lincoln, so that is one part of it. The second part of it is when you have graduation, they were eligible to apply for the certificate course. And that certificate is the exam. When you have that exam, then your certificate is valid all over the world and you can practice it.
Okay, that's like the exam they have to do.
And only success rate is around 98% when I graduated from Lincoln University.
Do you have any MS courses?
We don't have. Our university doesn't have, but US you have it, in Canada you have it.
Okay.
One of these students talked last time, she is going to do MS in Canada. So if you can do MS in university, if it's not our university, there are other universities you can do it.
So this degree is also applicable in Canada also. So same that you have to go and license exam. They don't give
you for you the have, so you have given the license exam. It's basically valid. Now for ES, they will see what ES you have done. At the academic qualification, they will see. And once you have done graduation, that is ES, full ES degree program, then you are eligible to apply for ES. They will have a criteria. The criteria is different in favor of, because you have already graduated. So masters and what about this course, the GPA, it should be determined by the university for us.
Sir, in ES course from which students are qualified for
beginning to see the eligibility criteria that is the end site also you can find, but it is basically a 10
प्रगटे आस जड़ता त्यागी युग युग का
Thank you. Thank you very much.